speaking for myself, this edifice of the Constitution and read as a whole, as a text, is premised on one fundamental principle, that is self-governance. And the most important is that right of vote.
Yes.
No one is arguing that.
Yes.
Now, people had voted for a particular political party. And I don't know, I had given a written order, and why the commission is shying away from showing its bona fides that it did its best to make the conduct the elections fairly just, because that is very crucial. And here we have a situation where the major political party for which the actual stakeholders had voted, they were, whether it was mala fide or for whatever reason, were excluded from that political process. It is about the fundamental rights of the people. It's not about political parties. But again, you see, when we come to 51D, you see, it's exclusively the right of the political parties. It does not give any weightage to the independents. It's all about exclusion. Yes, as my Lord has correctly stated, there were serious questions raised regarding the elections that were conducted in 2018. And it had raised serious questions on the Election Commission as well. So are we going to repeat that? Are we just remain silent about it and allow the people to suffer and their fundamental rights be violated? And that is what is not being argued on behalf of those actual stakeholders.
My Lord, and that vote is reflected in terms of adopting a system of proportionate representation. If that is not adopted, what will happen is a minority government is converted into a government which has two-thirds majority. That should not happen. That is disproportionate representation. My Lord, now to the point of these independents. Now, the learned Attorney General had said that the way these seats are distributed, this leftover seat, so-called, is because independents are to be excluded. Where are the independents? Page 5, dekhiyega aap, CMA 5840 of 2024. Ye independents kaha ja raha hai? These are not independents.
CMA,
ye election commission ki hai, 5840 of 2024, page 5.
Part 1 mein, no?
जी सर
फाइव
पेज फाइव सर जो इनको फॉर्मुलेशंस
अभी तो आप इंडिपेंडेंट नहीं है इस वक्त
नहीं मैं आपको दिखा वही बात दिस इज एग्जैक्टली
यू आर नॉट इंडिपेंडेंट एट प्रेजेंट बट एट द टाइम व्हेन द सीट्स वर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड यू आर इंडिपेंडेंट
No, we were not even independent then. ये आप देखिए पेज फाइव पे
आप पढ़ रहे कौन सा बंदर
जो दो लाइनें ऊपर की छोड़ दें उसके बाद में पढ़ ये डेट्स दी हुई हैं 15 to 2024 अगर आपके पास सबको मिल गया है 18 to 2024 This is what the election commission says. Between this period, independent candidates joined various political parties. Including the SIC, अब आगे लफ्ज देखें in accordance with and within the time period prescribed in the proviso to Article 51(6)(d), 51(6)(e), and 106(3)(c) of the Constitution, read with the proviso to Rule 92(6) of the Elections Rule 2007.
ये बता फैजल साहब देखिए जिस शख्स ने
इंडिपेंडेंट ने ज्वाइन किया जाहिर है आप एसआईसी ज्वाइन किया आपने
सर इलेक्शन कमीशन हैज रिकॉग्नाइज्ड दैट वी जॉइंड इन अकॉर्डेंस विद 51 सब आर्टिकल 6 पैरा डी How can they then deny us reserve seats?
सर देखिए साहब
या तो वो ये स्टांस लेते
ये बताएं कि अगर कोई कैंडिडेट जिसके डिक्लेरेशन भी एक मखसूस पार्टी से हो और उसी पार्टी के उसके पास एफिलिएशन सर्टिफिकेट भी हो क्या वो इंडिपेंडेंट होगा या पार्टी कैंडिडेट होगा?
सर इस पे इलेक्शन कमीशन ने
आपसे जवाब पूछ रहा
हूँ सर, मेरा अपना व्यू ये है, मेरा अपना व्यू ये है, दिस इज माय इंडिपेंडेंट व्यू, वो इंडिपेंडेंट नहीं होगा।
अगर वो इंडिपेंडेंट नहीं है तो क्या वो किसी पार्टी में जा सकता है
सर?
और अगर जाएगा तो क्या इंडिपेंडेंट के बगैर अगर कोई कैंडिडेट जाता है किसी और पार्टी का, क्या वो उस सीट का हकदार होगा वो पार्टी?
क्योंकि द पॉइंट इज यू हैव इंटरवीनिंग इवेंट्स ऑफ द रेगुलेटर, unless and until all of that is reversed, this question cannot be answered in the abstraction. Election commission agar consistent rehta to unki, this is something which your lordship justice Mazar had pointed out.
Aap kar sakte hain, aap unko keh denge sorry hum aapko nahi lenge, you belong to certain party,
yes,
aap refuse karte hain?
Nahi
aapne kaha ke welcome?
Nahi main refuse kyun karu sir, koi meri party join kar raha hai? But it is a point which had fundamentally been raised by justice Mazar at the first date of hearing at the leave granting stage, which is the consistent position of the election commission. If it wanted to, it should have said no, you cannot join SIC because it is not, it has not gained any seats.
Chaliye yahan pe ek sawal,
ye consistent position hoti ki 59
यहाँ पे सवाल एक
सब आर्टिकल 6 पैराग्राफ डी आप पे अप्लाई नहीं करता।
यहाँ पे एक सवाल और बनता है कि क्या एक कैंडिडेट अगर किसी पार्टी, छोड़ दे सिचुएशन को, किसी पार्टी का एक शख्स दूसरी पार्टी में शामिल होना चाहता है, एक पार्टी के टिकट पे इलेक्ट हुआ लेकिन दूसरी पार्टी में जा रहे, क्या इलेक्शन कमीशन उसको मना कर सकता है? उसके लिए तो 63 ए बताया गया है, पार्टी एक्ट में प्रोसीड किया गया, दैट्स ऑल।
63 ए किक्स इन आफ्टर द पार्लियामेंट कम्स इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस, इट्स नॉट बिफोर दैट। सर एक पेज इस पे और देख लें, इलेक्शन कमीशन की
सिद्दीकी साहब जी, आपकी पार्टी को तो बोनस मिल गया ना, आपने इलेक्शन में हिस्सा लिया ना आपने कोई सीट जीती, और 90-95 लोग जो के जीते हुए थे इलेक्शन उन्होंने आपकी पार्टी को ज्वाइन कर लिया, तो ये तो इट्स अ टाइप ऑफ अ बोनस रिसीव बाय योर पार्टी
thanks to the election commission.
If the election commission, it is not the question of election commission, yes, और ये formulations नहीं है फैसल सिद्दीकी साहब, these are the facts written by the election commission, not the formulations.
No, they
inke sun to liye, inke formulation shuru hote page 7 se faisal sindhi ke sahab, my dear
faisal sahab isliye aaye
ki acha page 75 dekh le aap
ji,
आपको ये कहना चाहिए कि उस बोनस का फायदा कोई नहीं
लेकिन गालिब ने इसे कहा
फैसला साहब, क्या ये दुरुस्त होगा अंडरस्टैंडिंग आपकी आर्ग्यूमेंट से कि the elections were free and fair, everything was normal, and you see there was some insanity in taking this extraordinary course by a major political party for which people had voted?
That is exactly why it was taken, and the record is before your lordship. If your lordship thinks that the election commission has acted justly, fairly and honestly, we have no case before your lordship. My lord, इस पे मैं एक पेज और दिखा दूं, पेज 75 देख लीजिएगा इसी समय में, and I'm on my last point after.
अगर हम ये कहें कि
जी
for sake of arguments, अगर हम ये कहें कि election commission ने गलत किया, then you have a case.
Sir, then your lordship has to reverse everything.
Again,
that is up to your lordship.
No case.
No, that is up to your lordship. But वो जो order है of allowing the joining of independents SIC, my lord. How was that order passed? क्योंकि ये सवाल उठा था कि वो notification किस provision के अंदर, वो मैं आपको notification provision दिखाऊंगा, पहले page 75 मैं लिखवा दूं आपको। Page 75 of this same CMA, 75 onwards आप देखेंगे election commission ने पूरा record दिया हुआ है on what day independents have joined SIC. It's not simply a fact. I will show to your lordships that it's not simply a fact. It's a recognition by the election commission that the independents have now become a part of the SIC. 75 onwards आप देख लीजिए. Now I come to under what provision does this happen? अगर आप इलेक्शन रूल्स 92 देख लें, इफ योर लॉर्डशिप हैज एंड लेडीशिप हैव रूल 92, If your lordship and ladyship may see sub rule 6 proviso.
Sub rule
6 proviso. If I may read, sir, how does this happen? Independents joining parties, the proviso. Sub rule 6 pehle mein, for the purpose of this rule, the expression the total number of general seats won by political parties shall include the independent return candidates or candidates who may duly join such political party within 3 days of the publication in the official gazettes of the names of the returned candidates, provided.